Good morning, first English students. So this video is on the paper English language. Okay, so we completed core five fiction and so for this paper English language, that is phonetics, I am discussing unit 5 syntax. Okay. So we are studying English language, its pronunciation, its morphology, its history. So we are studying English language, and the final unit is unit 5 and syntax. So syntax is arrangement of words, how the words are arranged. When we discuss syntax, that is how words are arranged in English language, we naturally have to talk about grammar. Okay, so how can we learn grammar? So that is the most important question. How can we learn grammar? Okay, so that is what we are discussing. So the traditional grammar, that is definition, example and exercise. Traditional grammar is rejected, and when traditional grammar was rejected, structural linguistics came up, and then ICA, that is immediate constituent analysis, also came up. And now in this video we will discuss phrase structure grammar, PSG. Phrase structure grammar. Okay, so by this grammar, how can we learn English language? What kind of grammar is this? Okay, so today we follow transformational generative grammar. Okay, let me again say, today we follow transformational generative grammar. Before the advent of TG grammar, that is transformational generative grammar, we had a PSG, that is phrase structure grammar, and ICA, immediate constituent analysis, and structural linguistics. Okay, so TG grammar, transformational generative grammar, is advancement of all this advancement or development of all these grammars. Okay, so therefore the most important topic in this unit is going to be transformational generative grammar, but in this video we will discuss only phrase structure grammar. Before discussing transformational generative grammar, we have to discuss these topics, because TG grammar is nothing but the advancement or the development of these grammars. Okay, so TG grammar is immediate advancement or development of PSG, that is phrase structure grammar. Okay, so what do you mean by phrase structure grammar? This is an improved method of structural grammar. This was introduced by Noam Chomsky. Okay, so the summary which I have written will be sent to you. So this is improved method of structural grammar. For each and every grammar there are advantages and limitations. Whatever the method of grammar could be, we have to practice the language. Okay, out of interest we ourselves should practice the language, then only we can learn English language or any other language. Okay, so that this is the reality. Okay, but these are in what ways we can learn the grammar, and how can we learn the language as quick as possible. Okay, so that is the thing we have to do. So phrase structure grammar, and this grammar was introduced by Noam Chomsky. Okay, so this is the improved method of structural grammar, ICA, and after that TG grammar is improved method of phrase structure. In this video we are discussing phrase structure, and this is TG grammar is advancement, the improved method of phrase structure grammar. And phrase structure grammar itself is improved method of ICA and structural grammar. Okay. So here in this phrase structure grammar, the basement of phrase structure grammar, not only phrase structure grammar, if you take any grammar, the basement of any grammar is a sentence or a phrase. The basement of any grammar is a sentence or a phrase. Okay, and phrase structure grammar says that a sentence has noun phrase and verb phrase. Okay, a sentence has noun phrase and verb phrase. So, you all know what do you mean by phrase. A phrase is a group of words which gives an idea. Okay, phrase is a group of words which gives some idea, an idea or some idea. So this is phrase. And what do you mean by noun phrase? Noun phrase is a phrase which acts as a noun in a given sentence. Noun phrase is a phrase which acts as a noun in a given sentence. A cup of tea. A spoon of sugar. A cup of tea, a spoon of sugar. Okay, so these two are examples of phrase and also examples of noun phrase. Okay, verb phrase. Okay, what do you mean by verb phrase? Verb phrase is a phrase which acts as a verb in the given sentence. Verb phrase is a phrase which acts as a noun in a given sentence. Okay, I am writing a letter. In this sentence, I am writing is example of verb phrase. Okay, so I have written the letter. So in this sentence, verb phrase is have written. Okay. So noun phrase, my brother is writing a letter. So noun phrase is my brother. That is example of noun phrase. Okay. So a sentence has noun phrase and a verb phrase. Okay. So a sentence has noun phrase and a verb phrase, and noun phrase can still and further be expanded as determiner and noun. Noun phrase can still further be expanded as determiner and noun. Okay, and likewise, verb phrase can still further be expanded as auxiliary, verb, noun phrase and phrase preposition. Okay, auxiliary, verb, noun phrase and phrase preposition. Okay, see, I will take photograph and I will send it to you. Of course, when you watch the video, I would have sent the photo of the notes which I have written. Okay, so as you see my notes, you should also refer our textbook also. Okay, you should see my notes as well as you should refer the textbook also. Okay. So in our textbook and also in the notes which I have written, I would have written as NP. NP is nothing but noun phrase. Okay. And then VP. VP is nothing but verb phrase. and noun phrase is further expanded as determiner plus noun. Okay, so I would have simply written as NP is further expanded as determiner plus noun. Determiner, it is written as DET, and noun is simply written as capital N. Okay, so verb phrase is further expanded as auxiliary, auxiliary plus verb plus noun phrase plus phrase preposition. Okay, so AUX is nothing but auxiliary, capital V is nothing but verb, NP is capital NP is nothing but noun phrase, PHEP is nothing but phrase preposition. Okay, so when we expand or classify a sentence as noun phrase and verb phrase, we students will be easily able to construct more sentences. So that is the belief of phrase structure grammar. Okay, so phrase structure grammar strongly believes that when we learn a sentence, we should divide the sentence as noun phrase and verb phrase. And noun phrase could be further divided as determiner and noun, and verb phrase could be further expanded or divided or classified as auxiliary plus verb plus noun phrase plus phrase preposition. Okay, so that's how we have to divide a noun phrase and verb phrase, and they are nothing but division of a sentence. Okay, and this we can further divide noun phrase in a varieties of way. Okay, so refer, it is like a tree. Your sentence could be divided like a tree. Okay, so please open at page 189, and so when you open at page 189, the example sentence in our book is given in our book is, my brother gave my son a book. My brother gave my son a book. So this is how, like a tree, see this diagram, like a tree we can divide a sentence. Okay, a sentence. Okay, a sentence is could be divided as noun phrase and verb phrase. Okay, and the noun phrase is divided as determiner and noun. So example sentence given here is, my brother gave my son a book. Okay, my brother gave my son a book. Okay, so here in this sentence, my brother gave my son a book. In this sentence, my brother is noun phrase. And gave my son a book. Gave my son a book. So that is verb phrase. Okay, according to phrase structure. Okay, so in transfer, when TG grammar was introduced, today we study only TG grammar, transformational generative grammar. Before transformational generative grammar, we many students have studied phrase structure grammar, and so when transformational generative grammar, we divide a sentence as subject predicate, but phrase structure grammar divide a sentence as noun phrase and verb phrase. Okay, today we follow only TG grammar, that is transformational generative grammar. We don't follow phrase structure grammar, but it is given in our textbook. Therefore, we have to study. Why should we study? Because how transformational generative grammar evolved. Because of structural grammar, we had PICA. And because of ICA, we have PFG, that is phrase structure grammar. Because of PFG, we have TG grammar, that is transformational generative grammar. Okay. So how transformational generative was developed? Because of the PFG, phrase structure grammar. Okay, so when we learn phrase structure grammar only, we'll be able to learn TC grammar. Okay, so usually you divide as today we all divide a sentence as subject and predicate, or even as sentence pattern SVO, SVA, SVC. Likewise, we divide a sentence as parts of speech: noun, verb, adjective, adverb. Likewise, divide the words. So in this way we study grammar. But in those days, in phrase structure grammar, this how they divided the sentence as noun phrase and verb phrase. Okay, so a sentence is divided as noun phrase and verb phrase, and so in the example sentence given in the book, my brother gave my son a book. So in this sentence, my brother is example of noun phrase, gave my son a book is example of verb phrase, and still this verb phrase, my brother, is still divided as determiner and noun. Okay, so my is example of determiner, and brother is example of noun. Okay, so gave my son a book. Okay, so this is example of verb phrase, and this verb phrase is further divided as verb, noun phrase, and noun phrase. Okay, so here gave my son a book. So gave is example of verb, and my son is example of noun phrase. A book is also example of noun phrase. So within a noun phrase, we have noun and two noun phrase in this sentence. Okay. So again, the verb and noun phrase is divided as determiner and noun. So my son, this is the example of noun phrase, and this noun phrase is further divided as determiner and noun. See, let me again remind you, DET is a shortened version, abbreviation of determiner. Okay, capital N is nothing but noun. Capital V is nothing but verb. Okay, let me again tell you. So here, S is nothing but sentence. S is nothing but sentence. Okay. And still, when we write this sentence, still like a tree, this could be further divided. Okay, brother. Okay, example of common noun. My is example of possessive adjective. Okay, so likewise, we can draw a tree like that further. Okay, so how it could be divided? Noun could be divided as common noun and proper noun, living things and non-living things, countable noun and uncountable noun, concrete noun and abstract noun. Likewise, the noun could be divided. Okay, so as per phrase structure grammar, noun could be divided as common noun, proper noun, living things, non-living things, male, female, countable noun, uncountable noun, concrete noun, abstract noun. Likewise, we can divide a noun. Okay, how a common noun could be represented, could be written when we draw a tree diagram for a sentence. Okay, how we can, when we want to draw a tree diagram for a given sentence, how they could be represented. Noun could be represented as capital N, verb could be represented as capital V, noun phrase could be represented as NP, verb phrase could be represented as VP, determiners could be represented as DET, common noun is represented as plus common. Okay, common noun could be represented as plus common. Proper noun could be represented as minus common. Just the symbol, minus symbol and common. That means proper noun. Plus symbol, common. That means common noun. Okay. So, living things could be represented as, could be written as plus symbol animate, plus animate. Okay, minus animate, that is non-living things. Okay, male is written as simply male, and female is written as simply female. Uncountable, countable noun is written as countable. Uncountable noun is written as uncountable. Concrete is written as concrete. Abstract is written as abstract. Okay, concrete. Let's say let me give example for each kind of noun. Okay, see in transfer again. Let me explain you in transformational generative grammar the kinds of noun is given. All of us studied the kinds of noun as proper noun, common noun, abstract noun, material noun. So they are all examples of kinds of nouns. But in phrase structure grammar, noun is divided as common noun, proper noun, living things, non-living things, male, female, countable, uncountable, concrete, abstract. Okay. So common noun, pen, boy, girl. Okay. So proper noun, Prasad, Hemapriya, Melin Hanna, Tanvir, Tamilarsan. So they are example of proper noun. Okay. Living things. Pig, cat, dog, okay, non-living things, book, mirror, house. So they are example of non-living things. So male and female, actor, actress, okay, hero, heroines, heroines, okay, countable noun, pen, books, hair. Pen books are example of countable nouns. Hair, water, sand. So they are example of uncountable noun. Concrete. So this comb is concrete. We are able to touch it. Book. This book we are able to touch it and see it. So they are example of concrete noun. Abstract noun. Love. Okay. Love. Sad. Happy. So these emotions are abstract nouns. Okay. So now that's how a noun could be divided, and how a verb is divided. Okay, how a verb is divided. Verb is divided as lexical verb, auxiliary verb, as per phrase structure grammar. Okay, of course you don't follow in this way. In TG grammar, it is further developed. Okay, but in those days, this is how grammar is divided. That's what we are learning. So, verb is divided as lexical verb and auxiliary verb. Okay, lexical verb is nothing but the examples of lexical verb: run, walk, talk, speak, sleep, see, watch. They are examples of lexical verbs. That is what we do. But in case of auxiliary verb, is, was, were, am, they are example of auxiliary verb. Okay, can, could, would, they are also example of auxiliary verb. And lexical verb is further divided as regular verb and irregular verb. So ask, asked, asked, talk, talked, talked, walk, walk, walked, walk, walked, walked. So they are example of regular verb. Irregular verb: write, wrote, written, speak, spoke, spoken. They are example of irregular verb. And auxiliary verb is further divided as primary auxiliary verb and modal auxiliary verb. Okay. So primary auxiliary verb is, was, were, where, am. So they are example of primary auxiliary verb. Modal auxiliary verb: can, could, may, might, would. They are example of modal auxiliary verb. Okay. So that's how verb is divided. Okay. Let me stop here and let me move on to. Let me explain a phrase structure grammar in one more video. Okay. Thank you.